Difficulty is overall, it's pretty easy to beat. Even on the most difficult level, it's still, the AI is pretty lame in the game. They'll openly walk out in front of you. However, there is some AI in the game that will just knock you on your ass and continue to knock you on your ass until you die. But those are easily avoided. Boss battles are hit and miss, while some of them really, really work. Overall, these don't work as nicely as I would hope, especially on how elaborate and how unique they look. But it's a platformer for the most part. A lot of the time, you're going to be jumping and floating, and that's about it. It's not more of an action game. It's more of a platforming game. Think of Super Mario with blood, and replace Super Mario with, like, Alice in Wonderland. It's pretty much the same concept. It's just, instead of going to find Princess Peach and then having to go to another castle, you find a main character from Alice in Wonderland, and you go to another area, and eventually you overturn the Queen of Hearts in the game. Well, I did like the, big, you know, becoming, like, a monster-sized, Godzilla-sized person. That was, you know, only not too long in the game, so it was not as interesting as it could have been. Another thing I really liked about this was the unique pepper grinder gun, and I've never seen anything like it. It's basically a Gatling gun that's like a pepper, you know, grinder. So as you grind it, it's shooting out bullets, and that was pretty badass. But most of the time, your inventory is kind of, you know, meh. It's no God of War inventory, let alone, you know, standard issued video games inventory, especially guns and shit. But it was alright. There was some interesting points, but other than that, it's pretty hit and miss and can be pretty average or mediocre. Controlling Alice can be an extreme breeze in the most part. Jumping is pretty easy, and once you get a hang of the controls, there shouldn't be any problems. This isn't really, really complex, but some of the controls don't seem to function react as fast as you want them to. So this leads to some frustration, especially when it comes to action scenes. And I mean, if you're not a fan of the third person shooting type scenario, I suggest you don't play this, because the targeting system is kind of it won't help you, believe me. Overall, this game is pretty good, but it's just, it can never strive itself to be anything more than just a mediocre game. If you're a diehard fan of the original game, like I am, you could probably buy this, but I would buy it at a discounted price or used, because it's not really worth the $60 price tag, and that's with bonuses included. I would actually just put the, like, one half of this game is actually worth, just because you can buy Alice, the original game, which in my opinion still is far better than this could ever be. While American McGee's gaming art direction and everything was really unique and something refreshing compared to all the modern, you know, military shooters out there, it just really can't stand the test of time, and this Unreal 3 engine is just not working anymore. You know, it's not as interesting as it used to be. And that might just be because we're starting to get new palettes for new, you know, stronger graphics as we see in the what's coming out in the future. But overall, I mean, it's just not as rewarding to play anymore when you're playing in a bland, soaked-out environment that, you mean, you can play a PlayStation 2 game and still get some more detail out of it. Or, you know, Xbox with Butcher Bay. But I'm putting these comparisons really bad. But Alice is a decent game, but overall, it's not really worth playing unless you're really into the Alice in Wonderland thing, or you're into a lot of platforming. But believe me, there's a lot more platforming than there is in action, and I was kind of disappointed. So I'm going to give this game a 6 out of 10. And that's just being very nice. Otherwise, I'd probably give a 5 out of 10.